bats coming out of nowhere chewing my face off. Wish I had torches. Another teleporter. Some standardized maps. Oh god. Oh god, we don't talk about Might and Magic 9. That's cheating. But no, I know exactly what you mean. Escape from Tarkov's maps are like that, where you have a map of a zone and at no point is it the direction you think you're going. It is incredibly frustrating. Little rat, why? I'm just gonna, like, do that. I think I just gained a level or something. I don't know. I just gained a level. I totally just gained a level killing a fucking rat. Oh my god. Okay, let's do this. I hope the game stops while I'm in here. But the up- it doesn't- fuck! The upside to us gaining a level is that our mana pool just doubled in size, because the amount of mana we have is multiplied by our level. So we can now do substantially more offensively with regards to magic. Okay. Let's go. I'm gonna do intuition because I'm an idiot. And then we'll do some ethereal link for the mana. I really want to invest in lockpicking, but I think I'd be spreading myself too thin doing that. So we're already able to cast 6th level spells. I did check the manual and it is 1 spell level per 10 magic skill. So there we're going, like, we're gonna have some pretty substantial magic prowess. Hey, Billy. Welcome. Left of the troll place. Good god, Poop Chalk. Pull sword out, dude. Anytime now, thank you. You little shit. Magic missile. Alright. Let's get out of this place. It's silly and full of rats that I don't particularly want to kill. That one track. I know exactly which. It's like the Woods and the Goddess, I think, is the name of it. Right is left. Okay. Left of the troll place. Left of the troll place. A troll place left. Let us waddle in this general direction. I want to know while my mind is on it. I should have enough mana now to lob 2 of these fuckers. I totally have enough mana now to lob 2 of these fuckers. And a magic missile in there too? And a magic missile in there too. Oh, hell yes. I'm going to be blowing my magical load all over everything in this game, and they are just going to have no option but to take it and ask for more. I'm so excited. I'm glad that magic isn't shit, honestly. That's what I was worried about, was that magic was gonna be real bad. Wonder if it isn't shocks water. I actually don't know. That would be hilarious if it did, though. Fucking, let's see if we can kill ourselves here. No. Just ye olde bolts of force, I guess. What is this? I'll place the cook so we'll be able to free up some inventory space at least. Okay, where is these guys? I love that I can just cook all of these all at once. That is such a convenience. Dissecting the Pornomancer. Max level. Fuck you, bats! Shit ass motherfucker! Ooh. max level goon lord. Really, dude? Really? I just got done cooking five of your brethren. I did not mean to fireball you, but overkill it is. Yeah, the magic is great, especially when it actually properly detects your mouse inputs. Get out of here, you doofy looking little shit. Good God. It's not worth it. It's not worth it, little dude. Okay, there's also frogs, which are adorable. That one was sitting on a fucking lily pad. This game is great. Could you imagine, like, you kill a rat and you're just going to extract its ribs? Like, I mean, if I was gonna just cook a rat, I'd just spear the whole fucking thing. I mean, you'd want to get its guts out for sanitary reasons, but okay, our inventory is full. I guess we can drop our daggers. I probably don't even need a fucking mushroom. Whatever. I'm accidentally throwing fireballs and I'm upset about it. God damn it. My poor defenseless mana. But yes, exactly. Yeah, you do not want to eat the organs. That's a bad, bad move. Sup, spider? Sadly, you're not a spider, bro, so I'm gonna have to put you down and harvest your sweet, sweet experience points. Ah, you motherfucker. Immediate poison? Really? Really? Any Moria in here? Oh, there's a biggin' in here. Get fuego'd. Fireball's really good, you guys. And it's only third level. Love that. Consequently, yeah, the poison thus far hasn't been too bad though, and food heals us, so I should be okay. We got some bones, some ferns. Not really anything too interesting in here though. Don't remember this game being too rough. The only enemies I remember being really nasty to fight are the dudes that, like, they wear heavy armor and they're like permanently hasted. I remember them being a nightmare to fight. But yeah, past that I remember for the most part this being pretty tame. Okay, I'm gonna just map this out. All right, this is just a little side passage here, I guess. It's like, what are those shiny things? Oh, they're my daggers. The ultimate underworld vibes in this are real. It feels good, and it makes me miss games like Ultima Underworld, because they don't make that. Ah! Orch! Blessed Fuego. No. Fucking frogs. Like the setting. Yeah, I always wanted to run like a D&D game in a setting like this where the world is essentially dead and everybody's just underground trying to not get eaten by the things that live in like the Underdark or whatever, as I accidentally click out of the window. I'm not actually gonna cook these ribs. Well, we can cook some of them. World's Largest Dungeon's pretty fun. But yeah, it's not the same because like there's civilization and stuff in this, whereas World's Largest Dungeon is basically just hack and slash from the start to the end. I actually own the World's Largest Dungeon. It is a thick fucking lad. Good thing we have Underworld Ascendant. That depends, I guess, on who you ask. I've heard that game's pretty bad. And this is why I didn't cook all of them, so I would have a stack for the new ones. Yeah, I have both, I own both the World's Largest Dungeon and, the World's Largest City. They are both acceptable, and I've used parts of both of them in games that weren't based on them. Good effect. I should stream it. Stream the World's Largest Dungeon? What the fuck am I even- Oh, or Underworld Ascendant. I mean, if that's what people want. Oh, that is a fuck huge spider with glowing evil devil eyes. Fireball is so good, you guys. See that? That's a nasty fucking spider. Oh, and it's got like some weird, like, proto-segmented carapace. Oh. Do not like. I will take this emerald, however. Do emeralds seriously not stack? Oh, you absolute and utter bastards. All right. Give me that. Medicinal herbs. Gems do not stack. Man. Both at the same time. Yes, I'm like playing World's Largest Dungeon and Ultima Ascendant at the same time. Surely Underworld Ascendant, that would just end amazingly. So okay, so we make the powder. What happens if I add it to water? Add water to it. No. Oh, it's antidote powder. Okay. So I want to hold on to that. Let's see what else we can make here. What is green? Fern powder. All right. I have a feeling I probably shouldn't be pissing about with this right here. And descent to Undermoon. Oh, God. Oh, God. Descent to Undermoon is just... Descent to Undermoon as a game makes me sad. Like, it could have been so cool, but it's just Descent to Undermoon. Kobold Theater Dungeon could become large. Oh, shit. Thank you for reminding me, Ela. I actually found something. Quickly, let me grab a link for it that you might find interesting. There you go. Since you're beginning to poke at, like, solo RP stuff, that's, like, kind of a system for basic oracles and stuff to kind of ease you on your way. I might use some of it. Making it run. Descent to Undermoon? I don't even know if I could get it to run. That's the thing. Find the train suplex interesting. Thanks for saving. Gotta have it. I've had that. That's been my wallpaper on my desktop or my PC for years. Oh, is this blessed freedom? It's the moon!
Lord, we have located an energy flux.
Another one. Why are the immortals never content with their own dimension? But that is our eternal duty, I suppose, to ensure that the universal equilibrium is maintained. Where is the origin of the energy channel?
An otherwise unremarkable world called Exhausta. The supplicant expired before he could finish the communication. What should we do, Lord?
Let us send a guardian.
Okay. Neat. I guess we're a guardian, guys. No particular like six Mark Kafka, the trains. Yeah, the train suplex is like fucking iconic. I just hear zombie noises that wave. I think of the Super Nintendo Final Fantasies V is probably my favorite, purely for the character building. What's up, buddy?
Welcome to Arx, sir. Go straight to the guard room and introduce yourself to Carlo, please.
By Carlo, do you mean my sword? No, we'll be good. We need merchanting. I like how he's go to the guard room. Where, bro? I'm gonna waddle around and listen to people hack with their fucking mine lungs. Hello, chickens. Like 1, 2, 3, and 5. I didn't expect that. I have not played the pixel remaster of 3, and I have not played the... Did you know you can steal from people? You guys. We can steal from people. You know how I steal from people? With this. And with fireballs. The only version of Final Fantasy 3 I've ever played was a translated version of the NES version, and that game fucking... Holy shit. That game is mean as hell. Hey, it's another doggo. And a crazy man.
Apparently there's a powerful wizard who can summon demons by the bucket load.
Who?
You have to watch those goblins. Vicious little bastards they are.
I fireball them. I like watching them burn.
It's been quite a while since we set eyes on any of the Traveler's Guild guys, though.
Okay, then. Pixel remasters are good. That's basically what I've heard. I just wish they weren't as expensive as they are. I would love to stream all 6 of them. Just start with Final Fantasy 1 and just go through all of them. But it's like $70 for them on sale, and it's just like, eh. It's a bit of an ask for games that are, you know, in 20 to 30 plus years old. Hello, friend. Oh, are you a gem trader? I think I remember
Welcome,
you.
Welcome, stranger. I am Tefiok, the jeweler. I fear I must apologize for my meager stock, but the troll's strike has cut off my supply completely.
Is there no other place you can get your gems?
No, no. The goblins are the only suppliers. But if you can find uncut gems for me, I'll make it worth your while.
Oh no, you're not wrong. $70 is not a bad deal for the amount of game you get. It's just more than I want to pay.
This troll strike is driving me crazy. If only All right. someone could get me some gems.
I do not remember how shopping in this works. I do believe I saw it in the manual though. Let's see, friends and foes. That's the bestiary. Click the chests. Ah, okay. Here we go. Beware! A transaction is as effective as soon as you pick up an item or drop it. Alright. Okay, so he's got rings. I assume that the numbers are how much we buy for. Alright. Okay. So he'll pay us 40 for these rings, which I don't care about. Oh, yes. Blessed currency. I'm honestly more excited about the fucking inventory space. I'm gonna hold on to this regeneration ring. Just be safe. Alright, so how much money do I have? 1,300. Nice. Now, where's your swordsmith and or magic dealer? Troll strike. The trolls refuse to work due to awful conditions, and you killed them for it earlier. I don't know what you're talking about, Poyle. I'm a union man. We don't work unless we're properly compensated. Mostly. Those trolls, they threatened me. I felt like my life was in danger, then I had to defend myself. Okay, so we got a cleric over there, it looks like. Is anything worth stealing in here? Okay. Alright, priest. What's your bag, aside from wandering around confusedly?
You are not just a normal human. You are the devil. Help! I have seen the devil!
I do like fire. Oh, he's a fucking sprightly lad! I wasn't expecting that! Jeez. Nothing! You Guys, your priest had a bit of an inflammatory reaction to my presence. He's a poor monk. I love that nobody gives a shit. Oh shit! Really, lady? Villain arc begins.
Can't cast this spell yet.
Lies.
I see you.
I see you too. Delicious cheese. Alright. Well, now we know that if we attack anybody, everybody gets real upset with us. There's something about that, like, weird thrumming half-music background audio that plays that really reminds me of Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. I don't know how I feel about it. Sup, dudes? Are you the boss?
I have an urgent message for the king.
I am Carlo, captain of the guards. Our king, His Majesty Lunshire, is in the throne room. Go into the castle. Through the double door of the room with columns in. The king should be there.
Okay, progression. Map updated. Thanks, guys.
Locked.
I think locked.
I love that we can just come in here, take their food, try to pick a lock on their chest, and nobody gives a shit. This fucking game. Alright, room with the columns. I assume that's actually to the west. And Carlo's up and about. I know there's a smith in this town somewhere. I know there is. Just have to find them. See, that's the thing, is I don't even know what a smith's gonna do for me, considering I'm a mage. What's up, buddy?
Keep your hands clean.
Welcome, welcome. My name is Gary, and this is my bank. Here you can change your gold bars and gold nuggets for coin of the realm at a very reasonable rate. And you can buy shares, too. You can trust me, because I'm the wealthiest and most influential man in town. Next to the king, of course. Ask anyone.
There's, so, we could fuck the mine over. Interesting. Okay. You wanna let me in there, buddy? I just wanna know what's on the other side of that door. Yes, no, maybe so. Yeah, there you go. We're communists now. Dude.
Your style is absolutely ridiculous.
Guards!
My style is ridiculous. Sir, my style is fireball. We can't even open the door. You got a key? No. God damn it. Where's the rich guy? He needs to die too. Eat the rich. That was disappointing. Oh no, I'm out of mana. No, leave me be. I've done nothing. Good God. With you killing your trolls, don't know how this is gonna go. I don't know, it's gonna be interesting. I'm curious. It wouldn't be one of my playthroughs if I hadn't made it harder for myself. Water. Some very green water, but water nonetheless. Save me, chickens. No, you missed it earlier when I was fireballing chickens. If I fireball a chicken, it turns into a roast chicken. And they programmed that specifically, because if I fireball a rat, it doesn't cook the rat meat. But you better believe it cooks those chickens.
One more day in paradise.
Yeah, bro, it's great. Okay, is this... is this Royalburg? Double door room with the pillars. This seems like Royalburg. Alright. I bring word of probably fireballing your monarch. Hello, Mr. Monarch.
Alert the guards at the outpost.
At your command.
My name is Amshigar. I escaped from one of the goblin prisons and I've been sent by Ortiern. He and his men are trapped at your outpost. He says he needs help to clear the pathway to the castle, which is blocked by a landslide. They have also been attacked by a small number of Ilsids and will be unable to resist another attack.
Good heavens. These are grave tidings, Amshigar. You have done our kingdom a great service, and you have our deepest gratitude. You will be rewarded commensurate with the risks you've taken to bring us this news. This cave-in is no small problem, however, and its solution will take some consideration. I have decided on a course of action. You will take this message to Pog, King of the Trolls. His people are very capable miners. They have even helped construct this village. The trolls live one level below us. You may have encountered them already.
Oh, yes.
They are just as ugly as goblins, but five times the size. But relations are excellent between our two kingdoms, just the same. We've a shared hatred for the ratmen. I'm sure they will provide immediate help.
It seems I can't escape being drawn into these events. Well, I shall help you. But I expect your help in return.
Do not fear. You shall be well rewarded for this task.
Gold will do me little good if I can't regain my memory.
I'm sure it will all come back to you. The goblins must have given you a serious knock to the head, that's all. Don't worry. Now, I beseech you, take this message as the kingdom's emissary to Pog, King of the Trolls.
Yeah, about that. Let's, maybe not do that, but okay. Yeah, yeah. Pog, King of the Trolls. Yeah. Apparently we can. Nobody seems to give a shit that the Amshigar is just completely disinterested in everything always. That's the church. Grave tidings! Ratman killed the- There's a massacre! I did everything I could to stop it. I think I heard them give me money. We had 1300. He gave us, I think, probably about 500 gold, maybe? Which is great if I had anywhere to spend it, but I have no idea where I'm going. I don't suppose. Map notes? Ah, here we go. So we have Hafiok the shopkeeper. Okay, so he's on the east side of town. I am lost. I need to get up above. Amshigar has no qualms about killing anything that gives him experience points. The lady merchant near the gem dealer. Okay. Gem dealer is over here, so we'll just loop back because that's closer. It's probably best to just get as much of this mapped as we can while we're here. I think I tried this door, or was this the room with the potion in it? No, it's locked. Okay. This... I don't think I've been up here, have I? Almost die. Somebody said earlier that you can kill everybody and still beat the game. So, I don't know if we'll go that route, but... There's the bank. For whatever reason, I thought the bank was a gem dealer because I'm an idiot. I think that was Tafioc that was the gem dealer. So it looks like all of our merchants are probably in one convenient place, which would just be wonderful. Now what's this? Oh, I bet we're gonna end up coming up from there at some point. Maybe there will be a sewer quest to kill giant rats. Who knows? Okay. So. It's just a side shitter. Jesus. Hello.
Come and visit my shop during working hours.
Oh, you're the gem dealer. Okay. Start fireballing the small children.
Leave me alone, or I'll call the guards.
All right.
Leave me alone, or I'll call the guards.
So they'll call the guards. Whatever will we do? We've already determined that the guards are susceptible to fireballs.
Welcome to my stall, traveler. I'm Maria. Please take a look at my wares. And let me know if you find anything you'd like.
Alright, what do we got? Ooh, potion of invisibility, really? Man, potions are worth some serious change. Good to know. We actually have stuff. We can make potions. I just need empty bottles for them, which she sells, and which I am going to buy. Oh, runes. Okay. Can I open my... I can. All right. Consulting the manual. What cheesy horse shit. Terrible trading mechanic. Eh, it's pretty standard. It's what I would expect from something of this game's age. Okay, so if I grab Ra and Vitae, I can cast Heal. There is a speed spell, but she doesn't have the materials for it. Create food. Telekinesis. Ooh. Life potion. A key ring. Buying that. Because we can put all of our keys into that. Okay. Life potions I'm not interested in. Runes. That pickaxe is probably going to be a get. Torches are also cheap. We'll buy the pick. And then I'm going to buy... Okay, I do not have Ni, Ra, or Vitae. What can we do with Ni? There's a douse spell. Cure poison. So the thing is that the other spells that rune uses, we don't have the other rune. So yeah, I think we're going to buy Vitae. And we're going to buy... Oh, I can't afford Ra. I've got to be close, though. 100 away. I will sell you a cure poison potion in exchange. There we go. Okay. Cool. So now we have a little bit of extra spell. Three picks at the troll caves? That's okay. Not worried. Not worried, because there were a bunch of gems in there, so we should be able to come up with that pretty easy. So can I just... Okay, I can just drink water. All right. So let's mill down some of these herbs we've got and probably sell the potions. So we can mill down these yellow ones. I hold down shift, does it do them all? No, oh boy. Okay, I'm gonna drop this for a second. So 2-to-1, we can turn these into healing potions. Stay away from the sword, small child. Oh, they're not 2-to-1. Damn. In the manual, it's 2-to-1. You need two of the, oh, it's bottles of orange powder. Okay. Waiting for her to take it. Kid just goes running off with the fucking sword. Okay, we need a distilling apparatus. Might be a lab in the Human King's castle. Okay. To the other side of town once again. What is this? Mm-hmm. Do not loiter near the crypt. Can I get into the crypt? Oh, you just know that there's mummies and shit in there. Oh, there's a lock. Okay, speaking of a lock. How do we... There we go. Give me those fucking inventory spaces back. God bless key rings. We'll get the potion maker thing until a little while later. Ah, disappointment. Are there items that do damage if touched that putting an NPC's pass could be hilarious? Possibly, I don't know. Okay, that's you. So I guess we're probably good to just head back out then, I suppose. My inventory is so fucking full, though. I know eventually we get, like, an apartment in here where we can store crap. But, like, dang. Ah, oh, mummies in your crypt area looking for fun. I don't even want to think about that. It's an absolute horror show. Girls in the caves. Oh, just like right here. I suppose so. Yeah, if it isn't gonna like despawn stuff, that's actually a good point. So yeah, here we can leave some weapons. I'm gonna actually equip this one. Yeah, ours is kind of beaten up. Okay. Let's leave potion distillates. We have two different varieties of loaves of bread. I'm not gonna question it. Mushroom! Mana potion, situationally useful. This Amakar's rock, I have no idea. We have a shitload of food on us. Wine apparently only stacks to 5. Smith is open, there's a shield over there. Okay, cool. Can't really do anything with it yet because we've only got 9 gold pieces to our name, but we'll be back. Okay, I'm gonna leave, I guess, our alchemy shit here. Potions. Leave a stack of ribs behind. Paper with writing of dubious usefulness. Wait, one of these we want to keep, I think. Okay, this is our note to Pog. Very important. Pog's champ. We'll hold on to these that's interesting. These are both blacksmith's hammers that are weapons. Only one of them has durability, though. I wonder if that's... Oh, we can't actually equip this other one. Interesting. Okay. Jank game being jank game. So I guess in that case we'll just leave this guy behind. Leave that there. Alright. Quick save. The pickaxe, yes, can mine gems. That is the entire reason I bought the thing. Is because the troll caves are full of them. And I think there's probably also some in here. I want to give this a quick loop through. This green powder, this is actually poison. We can make poison. These are, yeah, antidotes. So we can, like, poison our weapons and shit, which is kind of cool. Yeah, so I assume we can move mine these right here. Yes. Yes! We're going to strip every bit of wealth out of this thing that we can. Although these are the gems that really aren't worth too much compared to things like emeralds and rubies and shit, but money is money. And no failure rate, that's actually good to know. A small mercy. I was gonna cook those rat ribs I have, but I don't care that much right now. Freaking frogs, man. I should have bought torches. Although I don't think I could afford them. Blew all my money on magical runes. Which, I mean, I guess given that we're a wizard probably makes sense, but still. I'm honestly surprised there's no, like, light spell. That seems like something that would be kind of an obvious get, but... It might just be higher level than I was looking at in the manual. Because I was only eyeballing like the first two or three levels of spells. Capitalism ho. Man, Reciteer. Certainly one of the games of all time. A light spell is higher than a fireball. Yeah, right? We have Ignite, which can light things on fire. But that's about it. All right. Igniter and user as a light source. Good lord. Hey, you know where Pog is? No? No, okay. Well, that's a problem. Ooh, a little metal key. Get up there. Hey, buddy.
What are you doing there, goblin?
Me, troll farming. Me has big problems. Trolls on strike. Tell me why. They not trust me.
So the trolls work for you.
Yes. Trolls strong. Them mine gemstones. Goblins clever. They gemstones.
Interesting.
Me need solution.
Well, I mean, your trolls, yeah. Thoughts on monks with regards to... I have no problem with monks.
We trained him wrong as a joke.
I'm just here for the shiny bits. Oh, like D&D monks? I don't have any problem with D&D monks. A lot of people, depending on kind of what kind of fantasy you're going for, tend to find them out of place because they're kind of a more Eastern fantasy, whereas D&D kind of generally leans more towards, you know, like Euro fantasy. But I don't think that there's necessarily anything too crazy about dudes that punch shit real good in a game where... Is that seriously just a light? In a game where you've got guys that can stop time... And they're running around in bathrobes, so. Were it me, I would probably have flavored them as, like, more just general pugilists instead of going for specifically, like, mystical warriors type of thing, but I don't have a problem with them. An axe. Yeah, okay. I think that's actually better than what we're using. Yeah, weapon upgrade kit. Look at the Gazari. Yeah, like, there you go. A pickaxe. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that we killed Pog, like, a little while ago. And I'm pretty sure I sold his jewelry to the gem shop seller. Yeah, that's... sucks for Pog. Heavy stone. Okay. Are they getting... That's a very good question, Drunkbot. A very good question. This track reminds you of Pathologic. Man, I hear a lot about those games, but they are absolutely not something I would enjoy, I don't think. X! Guys. It marks the spot. That's something. That is obviously a goodie. Ooh, there's no way. Oh, there's totally something. Where is it? Where is it? No, don't do me dirt. No. Yoink! Eat shit, game. I do what I want. I don't even know what it is. It's a fucking rune that I just paid money for. Son of a bitch! I guess I can sell it. God damn it. Not gonna sell it for the 800 I paid for it, though, sadly. Fucking kibbits. Oh, hey guys. Me crush you, me smash you to goo. Consequently, also fireball. Dude. How many of you guys are there in there? Like four of you? Buddy, I got an axe. You put that hand away when you approach me with your strangely... Just look at him! It's like fucking... very excited. Oh, you missed! Now you know how I feel when I misjudge my distances with all my attacks. Sometimes you just gotta hit a motherfucker in the face with an axe. Mm-k. You have plenty to rue? Plenty. He says that, but I don't know. Those gold pieces. Delicious troll cheese. So how many were in there? Oh, it was just three. Okay, I thought it was four, but apparently my first fireball actually didn't kill anything.
Locked.
A fishing pole. We did find a key, and I will be trying that on those chests. I just want to poke around a little bit first. I will take the torch, leave the food.
Locked.
Really? All right.
I think I've damaged my tools. A very successful attempt. Locked.
Okay. Let me check my spellbook really quick. Is there an unlock spell by any chance? I bet it would be high level if there was, but I'd honestly be surprised if there was, because they'd probably want to just leave that to the skill. Yeah, no unlocking magic, alas. Honestly, I kind of prefer that there not be spells that completely trivialize skills like that, because it kind of encourages you either to spread your skill points out or, you know, multiple playthroughs. XX. Oh boy. That's falling damage. Yeah, that kind of sucks, though, that, yeah, you just can't smash them open. XXX. Well, that's just too lewd for chat back there. I did get to the XXX caves, and they're going to stay unexplored. Okay. Oh, that's a diamond right there. Hell yeah. I was wondering if there were other gems we could mine beyond just like the basic typeless gemstones. What are my thoughts? I have no problem with druids. They're just nature mages, nature clerics. Druids to me fit more, they slot more naturally into D&D than something like a monk or a samurai would. Well, what's this?
Me know you have to move heavy stuff. We can do that for you if you get me out of here.
Who are you? Because I don't trust you. I have a key. Your voice completely changed. And also, you disappeared. I'm very confused. Maybe he's the alternate solution since we killed King Pog. Take these gems, though. Let me check my journal. Okay, so there's nothing. I feel like druids be NPCs where you can magnify their mystical powers. I can dig that. Literally draining nature of life to fuel their magic. I mean, that's how wizards work in Dark Sun. They defilers. That's the reason that Athas is a giant fucking desert, is because wizards figured out how to use, like, plants and shit to fuel their magic and make it more powerful, and so they destroyed the world because wizard's gonna wizard. This room is mildly suspect, but random piece of troll art. Interesting. Can I take it? No. This looks like they've perhaps tunneled into some form of mortuary or something. Doesn't look like there's really anything in here. Okay, I was expecting something. Okay. That is one thing that I actually really like that, I know 5th edition D&D kind of codified it. I can't remember if it was a thing in 4E, but I really like how with 5th edition they added, like, basically the third type of spellcasting. Whereas in, like, older editions you had arcane and divine, then they added what they called primal spellcasting. I always thought that was kind of a cool take on, like, additional power sources, and it works well for, like, druids and stuff. That's when I rewrote the warlock for Pathfinder 1E, that's basically how I flavored them, was that they were spellcasters, but they weren't arcane or divine casters like wizards or clerics. They were primal. They were, like, basically their power came just from, like, the supernatural forces of, like, magic, basically. Like, the magic that was there before magic was magic. Just kind of like the primal forces of space-time and all that shit. Okay. Well, my hope is that we freed that troll and that will be what we need. Imagine if some crazy mage managed to throw that process into reverse, draining people of life. I actually think that there's one character in Dark Sun that can do that. They can't necessarily, I don't think they can necessarily, like, make plants grow with it, but they can fuel their spell casting with people. I think it's one of the dragons can. I was gonna say, I wonder if that... Yeah, that sucks. Okay. Alright. So, I mean, I guess let's go see the goblins? Defilers drain life from plant life, but I don't think they can drain it from people. Whereas, I think it's... It might be the Shadow King... that can, like, use just living things to power his magic, like creatures. I've skipped the goblin place. All right, that's fine. There you go. Jem's got it. I was gonna say, if Jamalis were around, he would know. He's our resident Dark Sun nerd. That's a bag of rats he uses as batteries. Yes, you, Jamalis. Oh, hey, the rat respawned. That's adorable. Bro, really? Come on. Don't make me ask you a question. No delicious meats off of him. See if that troll that we freed solved their problem. Let's see. Vander, dump. Vander. Dump this. Sword, backup weapon. Okay. So yeah, there you go. The filers are kind of bastards. All right, Mr. Gem Man, is your shop open again? I don't know what time it is. I got shit to sell you, son of a bitch. Alright, what about you? Hello. Buy my shit. We got about half back what we spent on it. That's acceptable. Okay, I don't think... Yeah, you don't really have... I am tempted to buy torches. But not that tempted. Especially now that we know there's a weapon shop with a blue shield. Really? Really? You just walk up to a man and sneeze on him, you son of a bitch. If it wouldn't aggro the whole town, I would fireball you for that. Not COVID. 100%. Fucking can't even escape the Rona in Arx Fatalis. It's followed us here. Right in my mouth. Because we all know I just walk around with my mouth open all the time.